punishment for successful fraud, and as no espionage can cover the whole range of a child's conduct, the upshot is that the child becomes a liar and schemer with an atrophied conscience and a good many of the orders given to it are not obeyed after all. Thus, the secularist who is not a fool is forced to appeal to the child's vital impulse towards perfection to the divine spark, and no resolution not to call this impulse an impulse of loyalty to the fellowship of the Holy Ghost, or obedience to the will of God, or any other standard theological term can alter the fact that the secularist has stepped outside secularism and is educating the child religiously, even if he insists on repudiating that pious adverb and substituting